Established in 1961, IIT Delhi has been a pioneer in the engineering institutes and research centers in India. Does IIT Delhi offer tailor-made research apart from the standard research?
One change that is happening now in IIT Delhi particularly is we are trying to put the problem first. So once you put the problem first, then what happens is all disciplines come together. Until now, the biggest challenge that Indian institutions this is a problem all over the world anyway, that academic communities tend to be very siloed. My background is electrical engineering, let us say in electrical engineering, in electron devices. So I would only take up projects which I can solve with my that narrow specialization of electron devices kind of a thing. In the process, my research never really, gets into a complete system level sort of a solution. And, it remains only in the research papers and all of that. But with my electronics background, if I can join hands with somebody who can do circuits and somebody who can build the complete system, then my research will become useful for the society. I think what we are trying to do at IIT Delhi is, putting problems first so that people can come together and solve the problem. The air quality thing which we have seen today is also a step in that direction. We said that we want to solve as an institution the air quality problem in Delhi. Now, once you say air quality problem, now does air quality become electrical, mechanical, civil? It covers across the domains now. There are people from electrical engineering who are developing sensors for monitoring air quality. There are people from the atmospheric sciences who are looking at modeling the air quality. There are people from School of Public Policy who are looking at the policy issues. And, the people from mechanical engineering who are building all these towers and building air purifiers and all of that. I think that is what we are trying to do at IIT Delhi. So we have identified these grand challenges. So among these grand challenges now, so we give funding to faculty, those who are able to form a group and then solve that problem. So that way we want to be more impactful in our research and we want to see our solutions go to the people, go to the society. So that is one difference in the way we are now beginning to do research in IIT.
A research can deliver the best results if that research gets practical exposure. To have this requirement, how the industry and public sectors are open and supportive of the research conducted by IIT Delhi.
So that is also changing now. In India, for example, one of the issues has always been our higher education sector is all fragmented. For engineering, you have IITs. For medicine, you have AIIMS. For management, you have IIMs. For sciences, we have ICERS and IISc. For law, you have law schools. And so pharmacy, there are pharmacy schools. So since our higher education got fragmented, in the process of its evolution and in setting it up, now, it's coming in the way. Now, for example, the engineers and medical doctors working together, can result in a lot of new diagnostic technologies for the healthcare. But that is not happening so much in India simply because doctors don't talk to engineers or engineers don't talk to doctors, and that is one big issue. So what we are trying to do at IIT Delhi now is to bring these communities together. So we have, for example, about 2 years ago, we signed an agreement with All India Institute of Medical Sciences, and where we said that we will fund our faculty, you fund your faculty, and through this funding can we bring our faculty together. So now today at IIT Delhi, if a faculty member at IIT Delhi says that I want to work with the same faculty member, then once they submit a 2-page kind of a proposal, IIT Delhi will give them up to 10 lakhs and the AIIMS also will give their faculty members 10 lakhs and they both need to work together, can work together for a couple of years on using the internal funding. After 2 years, they can go out and seek external funding and all of that. So we initiated more than 50 research projects in the last 1 year alone between IIT Delhi faculty and AIIMS faculty. That way now there are many IIT Delhi faculty members working with AIIMS doctors on futuristic kind of technologies. For example, AI. There's so much of data available in AIIMS. And there are people who work in AI, ML kind of machine learning areas in IIT Delhi. So now if we bring these people together, then you can start to develop those AI algorithms for the future diagnosis and all of that. That is one thing we have done. Similarly, we have connected IIT Delhi with the Indian Council for Agricultural Research. Now we have signed an agreement with ICAR, Director General. Now there are, again, we are following the same model. So now there are many agricultural scientists working with IIT Delhi faculty. We have done the same thing with the National Institute of Immunology. So that is again where we are looking at IIT Delhi faculty working with the NII faculty. So these are all the ways we are now bringing the institutions together, now which have very specific, very high-end domain knowledge. But by bringing these different domains together, you know, then now they can take up more challenging problems, they can work in newer areas, and the research becomes more impactful. So that is a kind of an approach that IIT Delhi has taken right now.
Normally, how many researches are carried out in IIT Delhi on yearly basis? Out of these researches, if we talk about funding, what is the portion of IIT Delhi itself and what is the portion of corporates?
IIT Delhi now, this year, in 2019, we raised about 450 crores of research funding from non-MHRD kind of sources, from other competitive research grants. So we usually see the industry component to be between 10 to 15%. So 10 to 15% of research at IIT Delhi comes from corporates. And we are trying to increase on that percentage. We have taken major steps now. We have created a corporate relations office at IIT Delhi about 2 years ago, and we have appointed a dean for corporate relations. Now the CSR policies, the corporate social responsibility policies, are also now modified by Government of India. So now we are seeing a lot more interest from various corporates to work with IIT Delhi. And now that we have no proper mechanisms in place to work with the industries, so now I would expect to see it to go up to at least 20 to 25%. That is what we hope to see in 2019. We also conduct an industry day at IIT Delhi in the month of September. There at least 300 industries come to the campus on that day, their representatives. That is an open day for us. We open all departments, all faculty members, showcase their research to the industry people. That way it is also leading to more and more collaborations between IIT Delhi faculty and the industry faculty. So these are things which are improving now. So from that 15% to 25% is our target right now, and hopefully that will happen, you know, in 2020.
What are the major milestones that IIT Delhi has to cover up so that IIT Delhi can have better portion of corporate funding for their startup projects?
Corporate funding can, you know, for example, automobile sector. We want corporates to be involved in the automobile sector, because, you know, what happens with corporate funding is the relevance of research becomes better. Otherwise, if corporates don't give us the problems, then we, you know, assume a problem, or we think that something is a problem, we solve it. But that may not be really applicable, you know, in the real world scenario. Therefore, many solutions that we have are sometimes looking for a problem. So you have a solution, but you are looking for a problem kind of a thing. So that situation arises if you are not connected with the industries closely. So that is where corporate funding will help, because in automobile sector, now if you have good tie-ups with the corporates in the automobile sector, now the future is all going to be electric vehicles. So therefore, now IIT doing research for these corporates, for these automobile companies, and these automobile companies making use of that research to develop, you know, future electric vehicle technologies in the country to suit the requirements of this country. I think those sort of things will happen only when you work with these industries. So that is one good thing that will happen. And also, you know, if you are working closely with industries, now once you not only have your research not only becomes more relevant, but the research also gets delivered to the community, to the society, because corporates will take up the technology and put out a product in the market. So that part also, you know, helps you know, from the corporate kind of relationship. But that is important. Therefore, we need to work closely with the corporates. And also now the startups is another road. So until now the startups were not really, you know, so prominent in this country. As you have seen today in that exhibition, there are so many startups now which are able to develop, you know, solutions to various problems. So that is also another way we can connect with the corporates. Now corporates can work with academia through our startups, because startups are speak the same language as corporates speak. They already have a product, they can demonstrate. So corporates can fund these companies, own some equity in those companies, help market those companies, help make these technologies more robust. So now I think a new model that is evolving is industry doesn't work directly with academia. Industry works with academia through the startups. So that is a new kind of a model which is evolving at IIT Delhi. Now I am seeing more and more corporates wanting to work with these startups, and through these startups they want to work with IIT. So which is also a good thing that is happening.
Indian pulp and paper industry is coming out as a multi-billion dollar industry. Any engineering course which IIT Delhi offers for the beneficial of Indian pulp and paper industry?
Right now we have many startups in that space, but a lot of this work also gets done we have a very nice textile and fiber engineering program. In fact, IIT Delhi is the only institution which has a full-fledged textile department, a very famous popular kind of a department. We have expanded the scope of textile into textile and fiber. There are many people who are also looking at issues related to pulp and paper industry in that. There are chemical engineering faculty who are also involved in
some of the wood segment, wood and agro-based segment.
There are people in the Center for Rural Development and Technologies, the CRDT. There are many faculty members who also work in the pulp and paper based technology. So though we don't have an independent entity which focuses on that, but there are faculty members in multiple departments who work in some of these pulp and paper based industries.
IIT Delhi offer and course. See, any new courses which are you see in future that will be beneficial for the students? Any new courses you are going to launch?
This year in 2019, we are starting an MSc program in economics. Economics, there is going to be an MSc program. We are starting another MSc program in cognitive sciences that will start. We are starting an MTech program this year on cyber security. That's also starting. We are also starting a BTech program in material science. So there is going to be a BTech program in materials engineering. The exact name of that is BTech in Materials Engineering. That is also starting this year. And we are also almost close to starting an MTech program in Artificial Intelligence and Data Sciences. But that we hope to start this year, but we need to see because it cuts across multiple departments. There are at least 7 departments which will participate in running that MTech program in AI and Data Sciences. So the discussions are still on, but we hope to be ready by the time the session starts. So these are all the new programs IIT Delhi is launching this year in 2020.
How does IIT Delhi manage the complete researches and startups and also support the developers in technology transfer?
So we have a complete technology transfer office. In 2019, we filed 150 patents. Exact number is 153. So 153 patents are filed by IIT Delhi in 2019. And we have a very high chance of getting these patents awarded because IIT Delhi has an excellent track record. And we have now a complete technology transfer office in IIT Delhi. And all our patents are listed on the website. So anyone can go to our website. We have the Foundation for Innovation and Technology Transfer, FITT, is the body in IIT Delhi which manages all the IP transfer, patenting and all of that. Anyone can go to that website. We have close to 1,000 patents now over the years what we have filed. Anyone can look at those patents and see what patents are of interest to them, can contact us and seek the licensing and all of that. So which we are doing very routinely now since we have a dedicated team. Last year we earned close to 1 crore from technology licensing, the IP licensing part, but that's just a beginning. So we hope to now have more and more technology licensing happening in 2020. So we are that way quite open. Any industry can go to our FITT website, look at the IP that is available and tell us that I am interested in this IP, then we can work with them for the technology transfer.
Generally, out of total conducted startups at IIT Delhi, how many startups get commercial exposure? Mean, startups are commercially employed in this service to the nation.
Now the startups have definitely made things different. So today, if there is an exciting development in a laboratory, now faculty members can go ahead and start their own company. This was not the case 10 years ago. 10 years ago, you know, there is something you have found, you file a patent, and then you expect somebody to come and take up your patent and all that, which usually, you know, doesn't happen. The chance of that happening is very low. But today it is not the case anymore. So if you have developed a technology, there are so many students now, there is so much of awareness in IITs, at IIT Delhi particularly, for the startups. So a student says that, sir, I want to take this technology forward and I want to start a company, and then the faculty member and the students involved go ahead and start their own company. So that is now happening more and more. On this campus, you find at least 100 startups right now. And I think any IP which is valuable, you know, gets now converted to the startup. This is one change that has happened in the last 3 to 5 years. Because earlier, the only way to, you know, do that was to tie up with an industry. But then in India, there are not too many manufacturing industries, and they were also getting their technologies from abroad. They were not even connected with the academic institutions in the country, so it was not happening. But now, because of startups, things have become very different. So at IIT Delhi, we have a major focus on startups. Startups by students, also startups by the faculty. Now, faculty members at IIT Delhi, if they say that I have a technology and I have filed my patent, I want to start a company, institute gives them 50 lakh grant to start a company. Institute gives them 3 years of leave to start the company, of which the first year is a fully paid leave. So we facilitate now the faculty members to turn into entrepreneurs. So that is a scheme that we have at IIT Delhi, and many of our faculty members are now making use of this scheme. So whenever they have a new technology, new discovery, they can take it to the market through the startup route.
How do you address the transformation of IIT Delhi if you evaluate the two-ticket operation of IIT Delhi? What are the major challenges IIT has seen that have been converted into their success?
Now, IIT Delhi from the beginning has been very good with the startups. In fact, if you look at unicorns, the billion-dollar valued startups from Indians, anywhere in the world, from Indians or Indian origin people, there are a total of 31. 31 unicorns, the billion-dollar valued companies, have been created by Indians or Indian origin people. Of the 31, 16 have come out of IIT Delhi alumni alone. So that is one great credit, you know, to this institute, because we have always been emphasizing on entrepreneurship. So many students here get exposed to problems and they know how to start a company, because there are a lot of alumni who have also done that. So they also provide that mentorship to IIT students here. So that is one thing which IIT Delhi has been very good at, starting companies and building these high value kind of companies. If you see any major startup in this country, in the e-commerce, Flipkart or Snapdeal or, you know, Zomato, all of them have come out of IIT Delhi alumni. So that is one thing which IIT Delhi does very well. And another thing IIT Delhi, you know, is doing now very effectively is the multidisciplinary research. Because to solve a problem with one discipline, you won't be able to solve a problem. You have to have people from multiple disciplines to come together to address a problem. Now that is happening more and more at IIT Delhi, because we have launched programs for encouraging faculty to work across the disciplines. We have launched these grand challenges initiatives. So because of Samandan, we have connected with all the good institutions in Delhi. Delhi has, you know, so many great institutions. Like you take AIIMS or you take NII or you name it, you will have one of the world-class institutions in Delhi alone. So that is what we are now doing much more effectively, because we are connecting with all of these institutions now. Now we are exposed to their problems. For example, in the agricultural sector, there are so many problems that the scientists have, but they need engineers to solve those problems. So that is where ICAR, the Indian Council for Agricultural Scientists, and IIT Delhi faculty working together, you know, is what we will be able to put out the solutions to the agricultural problems. So therefore, that multidisciplinary research, the culture of entrepreneurship, I think these are some of the factors, you know, which put IIT Delhi, you know, ahead in terms of solving the problems and all.